Good afternoon, students. In my previous session, I have discussed about that is resistance. So let me once again recall it, why because I have not written the formula. So resistance. So once again, let me write the formula correctly. So after that, let us see that is system of resistors. So what is the meaning of the system of resistors? Is how these resistors are connected in a circuit. So once again, let me just revise the previous thing what I have discussed. That is resistance. Resistance is nothing but it is the opposition for the flow of current. Even we have discussed this resistance is depending upon that is three factors. So resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. As the length of the conductor increases, even the resistance also increases. Then resistance is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. So as here the cross-sectional area, in a sense it means the thickness of the wire. As the thickness of the wire increases, the resistance will decrease, as I have already explained to you. Why? Because these charges will get enough space to move very easily, so therefore the resistance will decrease. But whereas as the thickness decreases, so the electrons will get less space in order to move, so the resistance increases. By equating this both equations, I am going to get resistance is directly proportional to that is length and inversely proportional to that is the cross section area. So if I am going to remove this sign, I have to give the symbol as rho, then L upon A. So last time I have mentioned to you, so here rho is nothing but we call it as that is resistivity. So each and every material, so based upon the nature of the material, different material they have different resistivity. So coming to the metals and that is alloys, which are the good conductors of electricity, so they have less resistivity. Last time even I explained to you, so this is measured in terms of that is ohm meter. So metals, they have a very less resistivity, that is ranging from 10 raised to minus 6 to 10 raised to minus 8. But whereas insulators, which are bad conductors, they have very, very high resistivity, that is ranging from 10 raised to 12 to 10 raised to 17. So this is what I discussed earlier. So the formula was not been written. So once again, I have written the formula. So this formula we are using in order to solve the sums. So here R is the resistance, so rho is the resistivity of a particular material what I am going to give. So usually they give a conductor itself, that is copper or aluminium, and L is the length of the conductor and A is the cross sectional area. So previous time I have said to you here the cross sectional area is nothing but it is the area of the circle itself. Now next one is that is system of resistors. So what is the meaning of this system of resistors? How the resistors are being connected in a conductor? So there are two ways of connection. One connection we call it as that is series connection. So other one we call it as that is the parallel connection. So even a 2 mark question can be asked based on this system of resistors. So they ask you to draw the diagram of series or even parallel connection. So in arithmetic, if people have studied arithmetic series or series, series is nothing but it is a sum of the terms. If the resistors are connected in one line, one after the other, then that type of connection we call it as series connection. If the resistors are connected one below the other, not in a straight line but one below the other, so that type of connection we call it as your parallel connection. So let me first take the series connection. and I am going to connect an ammeter here. So this is positive and negative. So let me connect one resistor here, then one more resistor, the other resistor, and this is being connected to key. So let me say this is R1, R2 and R3. So this is of resistance 1 ohm, this is of resistance 2 ohm and this is of resistance 3 ohm. If in this way and always we connect our voltmeter, sorry, this is positive and negative, in parallel. So this is the voltmeter, so let me take positive and here it is negative. So if the resistors are being connected in this way, then so this type of connection we call it as your what is a series connection. So in series connection, the current is not going to change, but whereas the voltage is going to change. Why? Because see, the resistors are connected one after the other. So these resistance is going to obstruct the flow of charges, so which is going to lead in the decrease of this voltage. So if I connect a different voltmeter here, so let me take this is positive and negative. So here also I am going to take this is V1 and this one is V2. So here it is V3. Then let me measure the voltage. So the total voltage, what I am going to get in the system of connection is, it is the sum of, that is V is equal to V1 plus V2 as well as V3. So according to Ohm's law, so V upon I is constant, that is what I have explained to you. Now let me cross multiply, then I will get V is equal to, that is IR. So let me substitute over here. So this is I. Let me take the connection that is in series. So I sent you, so the current doesn't change. So let me write I, and this one is R1, I, this one is R2, then R3. So let me I R S. So let me write I common, and I am going to get R1 plus R2 and R3. So this I as well as I will get cancelled. So the formula we find. So sorry, the resistance in series is Rs is equal to the sum of all the resistance. So this is all about the connection in, that is your series. Now let me come for, that is parallel connection. So the second one, how they have been connected in parallel, as I said to you. So they are connected one below the other. So this way. So let me take a license or a battery. Then it keeps, so always the voltmeter is being connected in that is parallel. So let me name this as R1, R2 and this one is R3. So let me use an ammeter over here. So this is negative and this one is positive. So this is how I am going to connect it. So this type of connection we call it as, that is your parallel connection. In parallel connection, so the current is going to vary, but the voltage will remain the same. Why? Because, so based on the resistance, so here I am using, that is 1 ohm, then here I am using 2 ohm and 3 ohm. So based upon the resistance and the capacity of the particular device that we are going to use in the circuit, so it is going to take the amount of current. So because of that, why I am saying the voltage remains same here, because so here the voltage is getting distributed here or divided, but whereas here the voltage is not getting distributed, it is moving in the same straight line, and since that you connecting the resistors in the same straight line, so here the resistance is very very high, but whereas here the voltage is getting distributed here. So for each every resistor, so because of that there is no change in the voltage, but whereas the current will change. So the current, if I connect ammeter here and if I want to measure the current, so it is the sum of the current in all the three resistors. So using that there is Ohm's law, so let me find, so I can write I is equal to that is V upon R. So let me write down, so this is V upon, let me write resistance in parallel, so this one is V upon that is R1, V upon R2, and this one is V upon that is R3. So let me write down this. So I'll take three common. So 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon that is R2. So the sum of, so let me find cancel this V and V. So the total resistance in parallel is in calculated the formula is 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. So this is a formula to be used to calculate the resistance in parallel. So another very important question, that is what are the advantages of, what are the advantages of that is your parallel connection, so over that is series connection. Even this also they ask in the examination for 2 marks, a very important question. So the first point is here the it offers very very low resistance. Then in case of series, if one particular resistor is not working, the other resistor also will not work, by because they are connected in a straight line. But whereas in parallel connection, each device has a separate switch, so there is no problem if one device also is not working, so the other device functions. So here there is no change in voltage, but usually for practical purpose, so practically it is used for the best domestic purpose. So because of that, the connection what we come across in domestic wiring or domestic circuit, it is parallel connection but not series connection. So this is all about that is the system of resistors. So how to connect the resistors either in series or parallel, then how to